It was a long and illustrious career at the Indianapolis Star. Rita Rose wrote for the newspaper from 1964 until she retired in 2007, 43 years. For many of those years, she covered entertainment events and profiled celebrities on a local and national level. It was a job with professional perks, including a star-studded friendship. Now, you were in charge of Annette Funicello's fan clubs, one of her fan clubs, and through that you became friends.
One of my friends, Bonnie Kern, who lived in St. Louis, I joined her fan club and she gave me Annette's address. And I wrote to Annette and asked her if I could start a fan club. And like a week later, I got a big long letter giving me permission to do that.
So you were the president of her fan club?
Well, there were several at the time, but mine lasted 28 years.
Wow.
I know, it's unheard of.
How do you know that she appreciated your work?
I did. I wasn't expecting that. You know, I was expecting, well, she'll send me photos and, you know, she'll answer questions and do things for the fan club. But when I got an invitation to her wedding, I was stunned. I think one of the coolest things that happened, other than it was the first time for me to meet her, was when we got to the church and we were waiting to be escorted down the aisle. Our escort was Frankie Avalon.
Annette passed in 2013 from multiple sclerosis complications. And Rita felt now's the time to honor her with recollections from those who knew her best. Now, you decided to write a book, here's my book, about Annette Funicello. This is from the perspective of her friends and fans and family. That's their point of view, correct?
This is my book, and I'm pretty excited about it because I talked to a lot of people in her life that were kind of in the background of her life, and they told me stories about her. She was exceptional in a way that she was very kind and sweet to everybody. Everybody loved her.
By the way, this is Rita's second book. Her first was published in 2008. Okay, you were also friends with Sandy Allen, the world's tallest woman from Shelbyville, Indiana, and you wrote a book about her too.
Actually, I took Sandy with me to LA in 1978, and we went to Annette's house. So I have a photograph of Annette, who's really tiny, with Sandy, who was 7'7", and it was a fun day. It really was.
Annette Funicello, from Mouseketeer to movie star, her essence captured in praiseworthy print. As they say, you can read all about it by ordering on Amazon.com. A fine tribute to a true friend.